Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Good morning, grade 6 students. Today our lesson is about Microsoft Excel. Okay, before we take the lesson today, let us quickly revise what we finished in our last lesson. Our last lesson was about creating a table using design view and data sheet view, where we learned how to create a table in a database using the design view and the data sheet view. Now, the most important thing in our this lesson, or in all the lesson of database, or we also call it Microsoft Access, are the five steps. Okay, let me revise the five step again. Number one, blank and save. Blank database and save. Number two, design view, go to design view. Number three, remove the primary key. Number four, enter the fields and data type. And number five, go to data sheet view. Okay, now in today's lesson, which is very easy, we'll just learn how to save a database and how to save the database with a different name. So the first thing is to open a database. Again, the first step, blank database, give it a name. Let me find a place to save. Okay, I'll save it on a desktop. I'll name it Create 6 Lesson 6. Create. Now let me create a database. That was my first step. The second step is go to design view, give it a name, student. Okay, third step is remove the primary key. I would say just name. For name, we all know that the data type we use, text, class text, grade 4, 5, 6, or we can use lookup wizard. Choose the second option, right here option, grade 4, grade 5, grade 6, grade 7, grade 8. Next and finish. Then age is a number. Okay, and date of birth. For date of birth, you can choose date and time or number if you are writing only year. Now this is my table. I completed four step, save, design view, primary key, and put the information. The fifth step and the last step is go to data sheet view, yes, and put the information. For example, Ahmed. Class I don't have to write because I made a lookup wizard. I can choose grade, his age, I can say 15, his date of birth. Okay, I would say he's born on 12 and 2004. Okay, so that is how we create. Now I've already saved. If you remember, the first step is save. Now if I want to save this same database with a different name, so in order to do that, I can do two things. You can use the shortcut key, or using the mouse, or the office button, or in the newer office or in the newer database, you don't see this office button. What do you see here? You see the file tab. So from the file tab or office button, you can choose save database as, or you can choose the shortcut key. The shortcut key is F12 without control, shift or alt. So if I press F12, it will ask me to save the table. Yes, I want to save. I would say student 2. Okay, click save. Now I have another table. Or the whole file, if I want to save it with a different name, you can choose here save database as. Yes, I would say grade 6 lesson 6 part 2. Okay, I'll remove this table by right click and delete. Yes. Now once you open a new database file, from here you can see I have both the files here. If I open, I don't see anything. So to see the table, all you have to do is just double click on your table. So this is how we save a database file with two different names. The second thing, or the last thing in our lesson, is how to open an existing database. Let me close this database. Okay. Let me close it. Now, I want to open a blank database. Okay. Now, the first thing is, I don't want to create a new database. I want to open the one which I already created. So in order to do that, you must remember where you saved it. Like I know I saved my last work in the desktop. So from the desktop, I can open the database file that I saved. Okay, you see, these are the two tables that I created in the last file. Or you can open a file also using the shortcut key. The shortcut key, that is Control O. Just press Control O. Again, remember the location. Select the file and click open. So there I have. Now I have my database file which I already created. So these are the two topics of today's lesson. I hope you understand. This is your homework. Homework in a sense that you have to complete these pages in a book, and you have to create a database from these pages and send me the picture. And the homework is page this on your book and the worksheet. I hope you understand. If you have any question, feel free to contact me on my WhatsApp. And the worksheet, you will find it on the school website. I hope you understand. Take care. Goodbye.